How's it going? This is Christian Espinoza with Alpine Security. In this video, we'll cover Zenmap. Zenmap is a cool free tool that you can use to discover network devices either on your home network or your work network. It's a tool that's really awesome if you want to figure out if you have any unauthorized devices or rogue devices on your network. Before you can figure out what devices are unauthorized or rogue devices, you first have to establish a baseline. In this demonstration, we'll walk through how to establish a baseline and then how to run a scan later on and compare it against that baseline. One caveat with Zenmap is for it to be accurate for network discovery, we need to run the tool from the same subnet that we're scanning against. This is because Zenmap uses ARP ping to discover the devices. If we relied on ping or looking for open TCP ports, we will miss a lot of devices because those devices, a lot of devices typically have inbound traffic blocked, including ICMP echo request. If that device is on a different subnet, then the subnet we're running Zenmap from, we won't be able to discover that device. So to have accuracy, we need to run Zenmap from the same subnet as we're scanning. In the video, we'll cover 5 topics here on the screen. As you can see, we'll cover what is Zenmap, where can I download it, how you can use it to scan a subnet, how you can add notes to the results of your scan and save that scan as a baseline, and then how do you do a new scan and compare that scan using Zenmap against the baseline? So first off, what is Zenmap? Zenmap is a graphical user interface for Nmap. All it really does is run Nmap on the back in the background. So it just provides a nice interface for Nmap. As far as where you can download it, you can go to nmap.org and follow this link here, nmap.org/Zenmap. Or you can just search for Zenmap and click on the link here. This will take you to Nmap, click on download. If you scroll down here under Microsoft Windows binaries, we're going to download Nmap-7.8-setup.exe. That's the latest version as of today. It will also work in Linux as well. I'm not gonna walk through how to download it, install it. I trust you can do that yourself. Once you have it downloaded, we're going to run it. So go ahead and click on the desktop icon that shows up after you install it. I'm going to scan the subnet I'm on. I'm going to scan that subnet. So let's do an IP config. I'm at a hotel and I'm on the 172.20.8.21. That's my IP address. I'm actually on the 172.20.0.0. subnet with a /20. Just to make this go a little bit faster, I'm going to change the /20 to a /28. Actually, I'd change it to a 24 just to make it go faster. If you're using this against your home network, you're going to put your home network up here, which may be 192.168.1.0/24. In my case, I'll do 172.20.8.0/24. It automatically fills in this command right here. We're gonna change this though, because we're gonna change the scan to just be what I call a discovery scan. So let's change this to a -PN, capital P, lowercase n. That means don't ping the host, just assume it's online. Then we'll do a -N, which means we don't really need to go and do a reverse lookup of the IP address to the host name. And then we'll do a -F, a capital F, which will do a fast scan, which means it will scan for the top 100 ports. Once this is set up, I'm gonna save this profile. So go to profile here, new profile or command. It should automatically fill in the command right here. I'm gonna name this discovery scan. Click on save changes. Go ahead and click on scan now. And right now it's going to start scanning this subnet. You can see by this bar right here, it's moving like up and down. That shows it's still running. When it's finished running, you'll see the results will pop up here in this window, and you'll see the host and ports, the topology, etc. And you can see right here under scans, it's still running. While that's running, I'll show you a couple things. If you go to the command prompt and just type in Nmap, as I mentioned, when you run Zenmap, it actually runs Nmap on the background, in the background. I did a dash capital F. If we scroll down here, we can find the capital F, which means fast mode right there. It'll scan the top 100 ports. By default, Nmap scans for the top 1,000. I did a dash N, which means never do a DNS resolution. And we did a dash PN, which treats all hosts as online. By default, if you don't do the dash PN, Nmap will first ping a host or do an ARP ping against that host. And if it's not online, it will, if it doesn't receive a response, it will assume it's down. All right, it looks like it finally stopped scanning. So we can see the output here. All these devices on the left are all the devices on the subnet we scanned that were discovered. So there's quite a few. Again, I'm at a hotel network scanning the wireless subnet. And we can see by these results, it looks like quite a few iPhones are connected to the wireless network. We see Apple here, Apple here, Samsung, which is probably an Android phone. We see a lot of devices here that are attached, another Apple. But the cool thing is, like with this one right here, because we did the dash PN and because we're on the same subnet, we're able to figure out what devices are on our subnet without any ports being open on that device or without having to ping that device. That's why I said earlier, we need to run the scan from the same subnet. You can click on services here, and this will show you all the services discovered on this particular subnet. Quite a few services. If I were up to nefarious activity, I'm sure I could probably get into one of these systems on the hotel network here. If I click on host over here, and I want to make a note or a comment about one of the hosts, because this again might be your baseline. If you know what these devices are, which you should know if this is your home network or your work environment, you should make a comment here about the device. Normally, we would have the name of the device as well, but since I chose not to do the DNS lookup, we don't have the name. But this device here might be, let's say, your domain controller. So you can make some comments here about the devices and save these. You can make this one here. Let's say this is an unknown device. We scroll back up here, there's domain controller unknown, and then we want to save these results. This will be our baseline. Again, we're using Zenmap as a free tool to establish a baseline and discover devices on our network. Go up here to scan, save scan. I'm going to save it on my C drive on this test directory. I'll call this one Discovery 1. It's going to save it as an XML file. That's fine. Now what I'm going to do is run another scan and compare it against Discovery 1. And we can do this comparison with both results using Zenmap. I'll go ahead and close Zenmap for now. I'll open Zenmap back up. You notice it went by default to the Discovery scan right there. I'm going to run the scan again. So just click on scan right here, run this again. And the idea is once you've established a baseline, you should run the scan every couple days, depends on your risk tolerance, to look for new devices or rogue devices on your network. If it's your home network, you probably don't need to run it that often, but if it's your work environment, you should run it on a routine basis to see what new devices pop up. I'll go ahead and click on scan there. This will take a while to run. When this is finished, we'll do a comparison against Discovery Scan 1 and Discovery Scan 2. It looks like the second scan has finished. So we're going to save this scan and do a comparison against the first one. Since I'm on a hotel network, I expect there'll be some differences as people come on the wireless network and get off of it. It should not be like this on your home network, but on a work network, you might see something similar. I don't remember seeing this one-touch phone or OnePlus tech phone there before as an example. So let's go up here to scan, save scan. I'm gonna go back to the test directory I was before. We'll call this one Discovery 2. Discovery 1 is what we called the first scan. Save that. Now that we have both of them saved, let's go up here to Tools, Compare Results. And this is an awesome way of comparing two different scans. And as I mentioned, the use case for this, scan A is your baseline, scan B is a new scan later on. And you could turn scan B into your baseline later on, but you need to validate the additional devices that are found on scan B. Let's go ahead and open for A scan or scan A, our Discovery 1 file. So let's go to C, test is where I put it, Discovery 1. That's our baseline. We'll compare this with Discovery 2 right here. And we'll maximize this. So what's in red up there is Discovery 1 or our baseline. You can see by the timeline right here, this was October 17, 2138. This is the date of the second scan, which is in green. So the items that show up with no color were on both scans. The ones that show up with the new color were on the first scan, but not the second scan. The ones that show up with the green color were on the second scan, but not the first scan. So let's just scroll here, for instance. And you notice this is kind of interesting. This device right here, 172.20.8.12, shows different ports open between the scans. On the first scan, on the baseline, we had 87 filtered ports. On the new scan, we have 77 closed ports there. So it's kind of interesting. And then you can look at the output of each scan individually here as well. So this one, the first device that discovered on the baseline is 8.4, which had port 88 as filtered. Over here, on the other one, we had the first device we discovered is 8.7. So we didn't see 8.4 on the first scan, we saw 8.7. Let's scroll down here and find those, 8.4. So 8.4 was on the first scan, the baseline, that's why it's red, but it's not on the second one. And then here we have on the second one, we have 8.7. Let's see, do we have 8.7? We have 8.7 on both of them. So if we find 8.7, should be further down here, 8.55, 8.67, 8.7. You notice it shows up in normal looking color because it's on both and there's no changes between the two. This is the easy way to, relatively easy way to do a comparison between an initial scan and a new scan so you can figure out what devices are now new or what new ports opened up on your network. And just as a recap, we only did the dash F, and I can bring this up here. We did the dash F, which just discovers the top 100 ports. If you want to discover all ports, you can do a dash P dash, which will discover ports 1 through 65,535. So dash P dash, which will take a lot longer to run because we're scanning a lot more ports than 100. But if you do that, that will scan all ports. It will be much more accurate. If you want to know if like a new port opened up on a device, for instance, then it's not one of the top 100 ports. But just for discovery, the dash F should be good enough. Just as a recap, what we covered here was Zenmap. It's a graphical user interface for Nmap. We talked about how this is only accurate if you're on the same subnet. We showed you where to download it. We showed you how to do a baseline, save that, then do a new scan and do a comparison between the two in Zenmap itself. I hope this video was useful. A lot of people think they have to buy some expensive tool in order to do network discovery, but you can do it with Zenmap, which is not the fanciest way of doing it, but it is a way of doing it, especially if you have a small network, or if you just want to get an idea of what's on your network. It is a good tool to use. Let us know your thoughts on using Zenmap. Hopefully this works out for you. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them beneath the video, and also subscribe to our channel. Thank you.